mean, feature management, if anybody's not using feature toggles, they should.
Things don't go wrong as often as they used to, which I think is a brilliant indictment for the technology and for the product itself.
Hello and welcome to another episode of In Focus, LaunchDarkly's customer success video series. I'm your host, Tom Totenberg, and today we're going to explore how the LaunchDarkly platform helps de-risk releases for Tide, a UK-based business finance platform. Let's kick it over to Matt Saunders, head of developer experience, to tell us more about Tide. Over to you, Matt.
We're in the business of providing total solution for small and medium enterprises for banking and accounting and invoicing.
Our vision is to save their time and money to get back to doing what they love.
Small businesses really have small margins, right? So every little counts for them. It's very important for those payments to go through.
It's very critical for them. The app needs to work, like the mobile and web app needs to work at any given time. So the reliability is very important and they need to have a really good quality.
Reliability is key, but that can be difficult to maintain as a business grows. How has LaunchDarkly enabled your team to move fast and succeed at scale?
Scaling the business is not an easy thing because we have to scale the products, but also the teams. And we also have to scale the processes. Our homegrown solution with feature toggles at that point, it was inadequate. We started looking at different solutions. LaunchDarkly was one of them. And from a buy versus build point of view, it makes sense to actually buy the product than actually build it yourself.
It's really vital that we have not only control of those releases, but good visibility, good dashboards. So we know exactly what's gone out to which proportion of our user base.
Before LaunchDarkly, understanding who uses these features, what are the variables that depend on, and whether these features are enabled or not in certain environments, we didn't have that visibility. So what LaunchDarkly brought is that visibility close to the engineer, and it removes that black box we had that only a couple of people know.
Yorgos, you mentioned build versus buy, a topic we hear a lot about. Can you explain how Tide made the decision to go with LaunchDarkly?
Our mission is actually to serve our members and to save time for our members. Our mission is not to build a feature toggle management system. The big advantage of LaunchDarkly is that there's a big and great team behind it that does a lot of work for you.
This isn't a random product that's been thought of by somebody who hasn't had their hands on a keyboard. And we're finding that whenever we go to support, when we go to developer documentation, you know, how to do things, it's written with us in mind.
Prior to introducing LaunchDarkly, I'll give you an example. So if we wanted to turn on a feature in production, you have to get an engineer to actually change the code, raise a PR, and ship the PR to production. Now that has a lead time, right, associated to that and a friction. So it's only the back end engineer in this case that can do it. Whereas with something like LaunchDarkly, it means that, you know, that's abstracted out into something that is accessible to not just the back end engineer, but also to the product team and to the design and UX team. That's basically the value add that LaunchDarkly brings.
Samson, sticking with you for just a moment, can you tell us about your favorite LaunchDarkly feature?
I love kill switches. If the performance drops to, you know, a certain level, you can trigger a kill switch, right? And that's how we're trying to link it to Datadog so that there's a performance and there is SLAs and SLOs. We can sort of tie into that and trigger things on and off depending on the performance.
Datadog, we love Datadog. Over to Cody DeArkland for a quick look at our Datadog integration.
Thanks, Tom. Let's jump in and take a look at what LaunchDarkly and Datadog look like together. Inside of our Datadog dashboard, we can immediately see which features are enabled or disabled from within LaunchDarkly. This brings all of the context of LaunchDarkly into the Datadog dashboards that you're already using. We can see all the events that have happened within LaunchDarkly, so you can understand what changes are being made live inside of your environment. We can see your application logs coming from Datadog, and any error rates that are happening inside of the environment. If that error rate is climbing, we can use a flag trigger to automatically disable that problem feature inside of LaunchDarkly. Bringing LaunchDarkly closer to your application metrics is how we take away the scary part of releasing software, which isn't the moment where software was released. It's the few hours afterwards where you're wondering what the impact is on your users. Back to you, Tom.
Thanks, Cody. Now back to the Tide team. Any final thoughts?
There's two things that I love about LaunchDarkly. One of them is the plethora of features. There's a lot of features that I'm still discovering new things you can do. And the other team is the team. I love working with the team. They're very helpful and, you know, always there to support when you need them.
LaunchDarkly gave us the confidence to be more creative and more innovative. Confident engineers produce more creative work. That's what I see. And they take that extra mile to give more value to our members.
Probably the biggest thing I love about LaunchDarkly is the visibility it gives us. Who's got what? Which components, which API components are where, and just being able to piece that together and have that all in a consolidated place.
It fits into our stack and our strategy where we're trying to go. We're trying to scale, we're trying to move fast, we're trying to be experiment and iterative driven, and LaunchDarkly just ticks all those boxes for us.
Moving quickly and confidently is the name of LaunchDarkly's game. Thanks to the Tide team for sharing how LaunchDarkly has helped de-risk their releases, and thank you for watching. Once again, I'm Tom Totenberg, and I'll see you next time.